Today, for our digital storytelling exercise, we're going to look at the book Crow and Weasel by Barry Lopez. This will add to our Native American storytelling unit, where we're going to go deeper into the understanding of traditional Native American storytelling and how it's used to portray symbolism. Crow and Weasel by Barry Lopez. Illustrations by Tom Port. In the distant era of myth time, when people and animals still spoke the same language, two young men set out on horseback to travel farther north than any other people had ever gone before. This is the story of a journey. Two young men leave their camp and go on a journey. We have read pages 1 through 32. And for this digital story exercise, we're going to be focusing on discussing our feelings about a journey or new experience that we have been through in our life. These experiences can be road trips, summer school programs, and any specific journey where it may be outside the norm of everyday life. Next, after the group discussion, we are going to create concept definition charts of what a journey is, the word journey, answering the questions, what is a journey, and what is a journey like? After our group discussion about what a journey is, we will be writing an entry into our own travel journal, describing our typical day at school. We will use descriptive sensory words to create mental images for our audience. The men walked softly among them, reassuring them with quiet words, slowly separating two horses out. They eased buffalo hair bridles over their necks and started them back to the village. The one named Weasel led, trailing a pale mare with dark brown ears. The one called Crow followed behind with deliberate calmness, walking a bald-faced pinto colt. Crow's eyes were fixed on the dark, silent doorways of the teepees ahead. Weasel stopped once, to finger blades of grass that had been cropped by an animal other than a horse in the night. This is where we meet the main characters of our story, Crow and Weasel. We also meet Mouse. And the forest in the story also plays a role as one of the characters in the short section that we read from pages 1 through 32. Crow and Weasel come upon the forest first. They aren't sure what to make of it, as they're from the plains. As they're going through, they realize that the forest is there to help them and guide them through their unknown territory. In the forest, they meet Mouse, who's also on a long journey. After leaving camp, the two young men rode north for some days over the short grass prairie. At the end of the prairie, they came to the forest. They had never seen anything like the forest. The trees were not at all like alders or cottonwoods, but taller, their leaves like needles, their limbs heavy, and their trunks dark. Crow and Weasel have mixed emotions about what their journey truly means, and this sums up the conflict for most of the book. They struggle with how far to go, they struggle with how their people may perceive their journey, and why they're on the journey to begin with. Crow and Weasel also struggle with the friendship that they have. They have conflicts between themselves. They run into problems that they have to work through as partners, which becomes a problem at times. "I will tell you something," said Weasel one evening after they had gone to bed. "When we started out on this trip, part of me was afraid and part of me was not. The part that was afraid had to do with medicine things, with what Mountain Lion had said, and a little bit with the unknown, that we were going to enter a land where maybe we wouldn't know how to feed ourselves. The part of me that was not afraid was like hunger. It was a hunger to be recognized." At this end of the section, the two men are learning about why they're on the trip, and the resolution comes when they both start to realize the reasons for why they went on this journey. As we come to the end of our digital storytelling exercise, there are a few questions that are important to understanding the book in a more deep manner. How do you think the names and depictions of the characters correspond to their personalities? The author takes a lot of time to create mental imagery through his use of descriptive words. Which words stuck out to you the most and why? Which words do you have questions about? The story often references the above ones. What do you think that means?